Good morning, and today I am going to tell you everything that you want to know about USBL calibration. So before you actually do USBL calibration, there are some very important things that you need to do first. The first thing is your offset. The offsets are mainly with reference to your GPS and where is your USBL transducer. You need to measure the offset of your USBL transducer with respect to the GPS or GPS system in terms of X, Y and Z value. And you need to carry out a calibration of your gyro compass first and your motion sensor. Okay? You have to align your gyro compass with the vessel's fore and aft line, and you have to align your motion sensor with reference to your vessel fore and aft line again. Once this part is done, you are almost ready to do your USBL calibration. Okay? So before you go for USBL calibration, there is actually one more thing that you need to do, and that is sound velocity. So you have to measure the sound velocity in the entire water column. Okay? So this is just before you do your USBL calibration, you have to observe the sound velocity profile. Now we'll talk more about the sound velocity profile as we go into our lessons. So where all we use USBL system? Well, we use USBL system mainly in three kind of a vessel, and they are DP vessels, non-DP vessels, and we also use it in construction barges. So what are the use of USBL system? The USBL system used for mainly for side scan sonar, towfish tracking, diver tracking, spool piece installation, mattress installation, or some underwater manifold installation, pipeline crossing grouting, and then again that's for diver location. So we can use this in a variety of the vessels, but depending on what kind of vessel we are in, we have to do that kind of a calibration for that particular vessel. If you are on a DP vessel, we can do dynamic calibration, which is actually the preferred method of calibrating the USBL. But if you are on a non-DP vessel, you cannot do a dynamic calibration. And again, on a barge, you cannot do a dynamic calibration. So for that, we have to do something different. For a non-DP vessel, you can do the calibration in a line run method. And for a barge, you can do the calibration in a static method. And earlier, about 10-12 years back, these methods were not there in any manual or any procedure. So I am proud to say I am the person who actually invented how to do a USBL calibration by a line run method and how to do a USBL calibration with a static method. So let's talk about little bit more about what we actually require if we want to do dynamic calibration and line run calibration. Okay? To do a dynamic calibration, we need minimum 30 meters of water depth. Okay? And we need to have one beacon on the seabed. Not exactly on the seabed, but about a meter above the seabed. Okay? Then you need to position your vessel at four different locations, or we call it a cardinal locations, around the beacon. And this location maximum distance from the beacon on the seabed should be half of the water depth. So if the water depth is 30 meters, your four locations on the surface where you are going to position the vessel should not be more than 15 meters. Okay, so you have four positions. You take your vessel onto those positions and maintain a particular heading and observe about 200 or 150 sets of data, and then move on to the next position and observe for another 150 to 200 sets of data. And you do it for all the positions. And you need the support of a diver or ROV to place the beacon on seabed and also to retrieve it after the completion of your USBL calibration. But what if you are on a non-DP vessel and you cannot maintain your position on a cardinal points? So how you are going to do it? But you do have the support of diver or ROV. So in that case, you can do a line run method calibration. Now in this line run method, you place a beacon on the seabed and you plan four lines, okay? Four lines around the beacon and all lines will be run in a particular direction, okay? But make sure that the distance of the start of line and the end of line should not be more than half of that water depth. So if the water depth is 60 meter and this distance should be 30 meter, okay? And this distance should be 30 meter. So it should not be more than half of that water depth, okay? So run four lines in a similar direction and then at 90 degree angle, you can then run another four lines, okay? So totally you run eight lines, you log the data separately and then there is a software tool for the calibration where you can input all this data and you will get a very good USBL calibration solution. You got that right? If you have some doubt, please let me know in the comments. So let me recap that again. Whether you are a DP vessel or a non-DP vessel, and if you have diver or ROV support, then you can run a line run method where primarily you need to run four lines in a similar direction around the beacon. And if you are on a DP vessel and you got diver support as well as ROV support, then you can run a dynamic calibration where you have to put the beacon on the seabed and you have four cardinal points around the beacon and you go there, you place your vessel exactly on top of that point and maintain a particular heading at all the points and observe for some 150 to 200 sets of data. So this is the way you can do the USBL calibration for a DP vessel and a non-DP vessel. But what if you do not have either a diver support or a ROV support? Then the next best thing that you can do is to go ahead and do the static calibration. So let's look at static calibration. To do a static calibration, you need to have four offset points very accurately measured along with your USBL transducer offset points. Now what you have to do, you have to lower four beacons from these four offsets simultaneously at exactly same depth. So let's look at a side profile of a barge. These are my offsets and from here I have lowered the beacon exactly at the same depth that is measured from here. Now before you lower the beacons in the water, you have to make sure that your barge is completely secure in all the anchors, at least 4 anchor, 8 anchor if possible, and not much of a movement is going on the barge, like they are taking in water or some heavy loading, unloading is going on. Then you do your sound velocity observation. Suppose this transducer is at a depth of 5 meter and the beacons at a depth of 30 meter. So you do your sound velocity observation up to a depth of 30 meter only. And you have to feed in your sound velocity profile from 5 meter to 30 meter into your USBL NCU. And that is important, not 0 to 30. But 5 to 30, because 5 meter is where my transducer is and 30 meter is where my USBL beacon is, okay? So in the NCU, you have to feed in the profile every 1 meter from 5 meter to 30 meter and in your USBL software, you have to feed in the average sound velocity, average of 5 meter to 30 meter and make sure that your USBL software does not have any previous calibration value, okay? Your orientation should be zero and your range ratio should be one. Okay, then you do a 30 minutes observation. What are the observation you have to do? You have to log in the position of the offsets and you have to log in the USBL beacon position data. Okay, now you are actually comparing the offsets positions and the USBL beacon positions. Okay, so at any given time the offsets are not going to shift, they are not going to change, so you know what is the distance between them and what is the angle between the offsets, and you take the beacon's position and you know what is the distance between the beacon and what is the angle between the beacons, you compare them together and you get two sets of data. That is your orientation error as well as your range ratio. Yes, there is one drawback in static calibration, that you are not going to get your roll pitch data. Okay, no roll pitch error calibration can be done with a static calibration, but on a barge that is the best that you can do. Any questions till now? So now we know how to do an USBL calibration on a DP vessel, on a non-DP vessel, and how to do a static calibration on a barge. Now let me ask you this. Do you know exactly what we are calibrating? Are we calibrating the transmission between beacon and the transducer, or any errors in the transducer? What exactly that we are calibrating? We are actually calibrating the installation error of the transducer. That is, if this is my fore and aft line of the vessel, I have to make sure that my gyro compass, my motion sensor, they all are aligned exactly with the vessel's fore and aft line, and my USBL transducer, it also got a forward notch and that is matching exactly with the vessel's fore and aft line, and that is not tilted or skewed in any other way during the installation. So if it is a skewed little bit, it's got a little bit roll error, little bit pitch error and little bit orientation error, and that's what we are exactly trying to find out during our calibration. Now you might ask, what about the range ratio? Yeah, range ratio is nothing but a result of your sound velocity in the water column. So if you are measuring the sound velocity very accurately, then your range ratio should be perfectly one or very, very close to one. Okay, now let's look at how the sound velocity actually affects our USBL position. Okay, suppose the beacon is right here in actuality, but the signal from the transducer to the beacon and from the beacon to the transducer may take completely different path and it may not be straight as it is, depending on the density of the water at that given time. And if this signal path it takes, then the beacon may actually show somewhere here in place of originally here. And if this beacon path is taken, then it may show that the beacon is somewhere here in place of originally here. Now this is actually exaggerated a lot, just to make you understand how this happens. So the signal is actually bending when it is actually going through different layers of the water, and we call this ray bending. And this is what you have to be very careful about during any kind of a sonar observation, whether it is a USBL observation, USBL calibration, or a multi-beam calibration or multi-beam observation. Okay, all the signals going through the column of water, going through the various density of the water, is going to bend. So in case of USBL, what you can do? So there are few things that you can do. USBL beacons normally will have a something called a depth aiding mode, So the beacon can automatically find at what depth it is, and that will help if the beacon knows that it is at exactly that depth. So this position, a depth adding in a beacon, can help you positioning the beacon very accurately. And measuring of the sound velocity profile is utmost important if you are doing a USBL observation or an USBL calibration. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching. I wish you a very happy new year and a better tomorrow.